Hello guys, welcome to my sixth class of Inverse Laplace Transfer. In this class, we are going to discuss one of the important concept is nothing but convolution theorem. The convolution theorem is very much important whenever they are having a function product of two in terms of S. If you want to find out inverse transform, instead of using a direct method, what we discussed in my previous classes of inverse Laplace transform, instead of that we are using convolution theorem, is easy to find out the solution of the given problem. Now let us to consider what is a convolution of two functions. Suppose f and g, f is a function of t and also g is a function of t, then f and g are convolution between two functions, say f and g. This star denotes convolution between the function what actually f and g. Convolution of functions f and g, where f and g are functions of t, is nothing but 0 to t, other than t I have to take new variable say u, f of u into g of whatever the t minus u with respect to u. This is nothing but definition of convolution of functions between two functions. Here I consider two functions, the condition both the functions defined on same variable. The convolution of two functions f and g is denoted by the notation star. You have to define, this is the one of the definition, 0 to t f of u g of t minus u with respect to u. Now the statement of convolution theorem here, I am not going to derive the convolution theorem here, only I am considering the statement. After that I am going to solve the problem, how to solve by using this theorem. If L inverse of f of s must be equal to f of t, and L inverse of g of s is nothing but f g of t, then L inverse of, I told already whenever I want to find out inverse of product of two functions, that can be written as it is. I have to find out convolution between these two functions, 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u with respect to u. This formula is very much useful whenever I have to find out inverse of two functions. There we are going product of two functions, we are using this theorem. Now this is a statement of the theorem. Now I am going to explain how to solve the problem by using this theorem. Now I am going to take one of the functions, say the function is sy, s minus 1 into s square plus 9. Okay. Now here how they asking the question is, find the inverse Laplace transform of this function using convolution theorem. Using which theorem? Convolution theorem. Suppose they are not mentioned using convolution theorem, you take any method, you convert partial fraction, and then all you are going to use any standard method, f of t by t, like that. But once you mention, I have to solve this inverse value by using convolution means, I have to go for this. If you want to go for convolution function, it must be a product of two functions. Therefore, here I am going to take, that is a, you can't take f as a minor or f of s and g of s. You choose f of and g of s. Once you apply the inverse transform, you are expecting the corresponding function in terms of t. You can't choose any whatever your required manner. See, observe here, s by s minus 1 into s square plus 9. Therefore, I am going to take f of s is 1 by s minus 1, because we know the formula. L inverse of 1 by s minus 1 is e power of t. We get immediately. That's the way we are going to take function f of s and g of s. The g of s I am going to take here s by s square plus 9, because this is one of the standard function that gives us what, cos 3t. This is the way I have to choose. You can't choose opposite manner f of s and g of s. Please try to understand. Once you choose that, apply inverse, we are expecting immediately the corresponding function. That's the way I have to choose. Then, by convolution theorem, that implies, what is L inverse of f of s? What is L inverse of f of s here? Now we already discussed so many problems, therefore I'm going to write 1 by e bar of t. And then what is L inverse of g of s? This is a one of standard function. That function is nothing but what? Cos of t square is 3t. Now I'm going to apply by convolution theorem. You must and should have mentioned name of the theorem, not necessary to write entire the statement of the theorem. Because this theorem have a name, whenever I have the name, just you mention it. Therefore, L that implies L inverse of S by S minus 1 into S square plus 9 is nothing but what actually a 0 to t f of u. What is my f of t is e power of t. F of u is e power of u. And then what is g of t minus u? G of t is nothing but cos 3t. Cos of whatever 3 into t minus u with respect to u. Now I should simplify this. In the next step, this can be written as 0 to t e power of u cos of, better to take 3 inside the bracket, 3t minus 3u with respect to u. You have one of standard function you already studied in the pure level. Integration of e power of ax into cos of dx plus r minus e with respect to x. What's the formula here? E power of ax divided by a square plus b square. Okay? Into a into cos of px plus r minus e. Okay, fine. Minus. What's the coefficient of x trigonometric function is plus b into sin of bx plus r minus e. This is a formula everyone you already studied in basic thing in pure level. Even though you forgotten, written already on the board, what's the formula? This formula you already derived. Now, from this formula, keep in mind we are integrating with respect to u, therefore u is only a. Here, in this function, u, what about a is nothing but 1 because coefficient of u of exponential, and b equals coefficient of u in trigonometric. Keep in mind, whenever having this minus sign, because 3t minus 3u can also be written as minus 3u plus 3t. Therefore, what's the coefficient of u here? A quotient of u is nothing but minus 3. Therefore, what is minus b is minus 3. That's why very carefully I have to take whenever having negative sign. E power of u divided by a square. What is a square? 1 square. Plus what is my b square here? Minus 3 whole square. Okay? And then I have to take what actually a is 1 into cos of 3t minus 3u. Plus, what is my b? Minus 3 into sin of 3t minus 3u. What's the limit now? 0 to t. In the next step, before applying the upper limit, first you have to keep the constant outside. What is minus 3 whole square? 9. 9 plus 1 square is 1, we get 1 by 10. Then apply the upper limit. What's the upper limit here? T. E power of t of, apply the upper limit of this. What is t? U is t. What we get? 3t minus 3t. What is 3t minus 3t? 0. We get cos 0. What is cos 0? Is 1. 1 into 1. 1 into 1 into 1. Plus into minus is minus 3. Again I have to put u is t. 3t minus 3 is 3t 0. What is sin 0? Is 0. Minus lower limit. What is my lower limit? Is 0. What is e power 0? Is 1. 1 of, now I have to put u is 0. What we get actually? Cos 3t. Minus 3. Put u is 0. What we get? Sin 3t. Yeah. In the next step, 1 by 10 of, what we get? Minus 3 into e power of t. Minus cos 3t minus into minus plus 3 sin 3t. This is the answer for the given function s by s minus 1 into s square plus 9 using which theorem? Convolution theorem. Again I am going to repeat. Where I'm going to use convolution theorem, whenever having a product of two functions, not only product of two functions, once you take the given f of s in the terms of product of two functions, once you apply inverse transform, we get immediately the corresponding functions. There I'm going to use very comfortably convolution theorem. Once you apply the convolution theorem, easy to evaluate. Even though the given function is possible to convert the product of two functions, but you can't find out L inverse of f of s and L inverse of g of s directly, don't go for convolution theorem. But keep in mind, in the problem, suppose they mentioned to solve by using convolution theorem, you must and should solve by using this theorem only. Thank you very much for listening my talk. Suppose you like my video, please press a like button and also please subscribe my channel. I am going to take in further my classes one more problem based on convolution theorem. Thank you.